for Brady and the Bucs.
Well, I think this game is really tailor-made for what the Bucs do, Skip, because Minnesota does not get after your quarterback. And I think that was one of the main reasons that they lost to the Cowboys in their building, is that they don't get after your quarterback. And what we've seen, teams that cause Tom Brady problems, all of them get after the quarterback. The New Orleans Saints got after him. Who else? Chicago, they got after him. You have to get after him, or you can't beat them, because he has so many weapons on the offensive side of football. He still has Gronk. Cameron Bray can make plays. He has Mike Evans, Godwin. A.B., you know, what's going to be his role? Probably A.B. is going to probably get some catches. But I'm listening to Bruce Arians, and Bruce Arians says, Ronald Jones, is where it starts. Really? I already said Jones is going to get 20 touches. Hold on, wait a minute. Why I got Tom Brady? If I'm talking about an offense, name an offense. When you talk about Green Bay, the first thing you don't say is no Aaron Jones. You talk about You talk about A-Rod. When you talk about my homeboy, you don't talk about Le'Veon or Clyde Edwards-Helaire. You talk about my homeboy. You talk about Deshaun. You talk about Russ. Why are we having a conversation about a running back when you got to go?
Well, guess what? Tampa Bay is 28th in running percentage of plays. So does it start with Rojo or not? It sounds like it starts with Thomas Edward Patrick Brady Jr. You're 28th in percentage of runs? Are you kidding me?
And that's where you got probably is in quarterback rating, completion percentage. Skip, look, there are a lot of things that Tom Brady misses about New England. He misses the discipline. I don't know if you know this, but the Bucs are third in penalty yards. They got 751 penalty yards. Pittsburgh's number one at 814. The Eagles are second at 772. The Bucs are 14th in penalties accepted. You look, that's bad.
I also know Tom Brady is third in times hit. He's been hit the third most times of any quarterback in football.
What?
And you tell me it's unfair. He gets rid of the ball so fast. That's how he's still playing at 43.
No. That's what he was doing in New England when the offense was catered to him. Mm-hmm. But you know, Skip, you've been telling me, and I've heard everybody say, Tom Brady would be good in any offense. Mm. You take Tom Brady, put him in that offense, he'd be great. I'm waiting.
Well, if you gave him an offseason and even one preseason game to try to figure it out, maybe he would be great.
No.
He's had none of that. Do you realize their bye week didn't happen until now? Isn't this kind of late for a bye week?
Well, I mean, he needed it.
Yeah,
He needed it.
Yeah.
I just think the thing is that, yes, I believe that Brady would have been better served. And all the things that are happening is the things that I didn't first guess. Okay, when Bruce Arians asked him to constantly throw the ball down the field, Skip, you know, in order to throw the ball down the field, they didn't even go get closer and closer to you, because you got to hold on to it. Because they know three.
Okay, but you thought he would slowly but surely turn it into the Tom Brady offense, and it's not happening.
I did.
It still bombs away. It's still no risk and no business.
And if you look at it, Skip, if you look at a lot of times that he's had success, he's nickel, 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 and then he hits you with the quarter over the top to Scotty Miller. Or
agreed.
He hits you over the top.
Agreed.
But there's been none of that.
Okay. All right. So the Vikings, as a Brady fan, they do scare me, because they are, according to Pro Football Focus, ranked sixth best on offense. And you keep raving about that rookie receiver, and he is fourth in the league in yards receiving, Justin Jefferson, who went a little later than Rager went, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the Eagles had a shot, and they didn't. For that matter, my Cowboys had a shot. I'm still happy with CeeDee Lamb.
You'd be happier with that guy.
I don't think so. But again, I cannot, I cannot discount his year, because it's sensational.
Yes.
And all of a sudden, I look at Pro Football Focus's rankings of receivers, and they rank him fourth. Guess who they rank third overall in just overall grade? Adam Thielen. Yeah. Is Dalvin Cook any good?
Yeah.
Do you know what Dalvin Cook did to Green Bay and Aaron Rodgers and company up there? He went for 163, and they won at Lambeau 28-22. You can argue they took him by surprise, but they won, and they've won 5 out of 6 games against mediocre to sub competition.
Right.
You know, they beat Detroit. They won at Chicago barely. They beat Carolina barely, and then Jacksonville in overtime. So they're barely beating some
bad teams. Right.
Okay, I got that. But they have won 5 out of 6.
Right.
And all of a sudden, First Cousins, as you call him, he's starting to cook a little bit. And he's thrown for 307 and 305 in the last 2 games. And I remind you, you focus on Brady, the Tampa Bay pass defense over the last four games has been by far the worst in pro football.
They're
getting torched. They gave up to Tyreek 203 in the first quarter. Yeah. The first quarter? Are you kidding me? So I'm saying.
Well, they're undisciplined, Skip.
Okay, but do you don't think First Cousins can have a game? Because I think he's going to throw a party like everybody else.
But here's the thing, though, Skip. When you look at Minnesota, the thing that Tom Brady loves is time, is protection.
Sure. No, I got it.
And they don't rush the quarterback.
Okay, so I'm seeing high scoring. And I'm going to close one eye and watch this game and hope they pull it out 35-32. Because it's going to be in the mid-30s.
Do you believe Dalvin Cook will be able to have the success running the football?
Okay, nobody does because everybody just throws it against these guys. But, so if I'm, again, I would try to run Dalvin Cook and see if you can establish something.
Because if you become one-dimensional, now they heat you up. Now Todd Bowles heats you up.
Well, does he? He hasn't been heating anybody up except himself. He's been on the hot seat.
Well, Skip, you got to be careful trying to run. Nobody is better against the blitz this year than my homeboy. And do you really want to blitz and have single coverage with all that speed outside? You probably don't. But don't think – I know Gary Kubiak. He was my offensive coordinator. I played with him. He's the offensive coordinator at Minnesota.
Yep. And he's a smart man.
He's going to run the football, but I look for Cousins to be on the move. He's not going to let you have a sitting
target. He's good on the move.
He's going to be on the move.
Okay. I got it. Where those two stud linebackers for Tampa Bay have gone, I don't know.
Make them play in space.
Where did the two Dallas linebackers go? I don't know. They just evaporated.
Well,
they disappeared.
If you notice what teams are doing is that they're going a lot of three wide receiver sets. They're making them play in space.
Okay.
You put them in that box and let them come downhill and thump you, or you let Jones and Devin White.
Okay.
Let them bitch your quarterback, you're in trouble.
All right. Now back to Tom Brady.
Yeah.
For me, this is make or break. This is a must-win game. And I'm putting it in this perspective. If they're the team I thought they could be, they have to win this game. You can't back in through December. You can't fall backward toward barely eking into the back end of the playoffs. Left on their schedule, they got the two division games, obviously.
Got
Atlanta twice. Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. So my point is that this is the turning point game. This is the one where you had a late season bye. Remember, you had little to no offseason.
Right.
You had virtual OTAs. You had zero preseason games. And you got thrown into the fire. Guess where? We just talked about Jalen Hurts against New Orleans. At New Orleans.
Yeah.
That guy had to start against your arch division rival on the road in New Orleans with no preseason. Not easy, man. The degree of difficulty is through that roof of that Superdome. Mm-hmm. And from there, you don't ever get a breath. You don't get to sit down and try to let it sink in what's happening. And furthermore, I remind everybody, when they got to 6-2, which is pretty good, when everybody's saying this defense might be the best defense in pro football, what did they do at 6-2? They threw into the mix or the fire Antonio Brown, a huge personality, a huge aura, a buddy of Tom Brady's, into a mix that was working at a very high level. And you took out of the rotation a kid that I raved about and you laughed at me for all offseason. I kept saying, you better beware of the little Scotty Miller because he runs 4.3. That's why. He's little, but he is a little bullet.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Tom started to fall in love with him. He actually became his best deep threat. And guess what's happened since AB got there? Guess what's happened?
Nothing.
Nothing. He's gotten five targets total. Five. They've thrown him five passes in five games.
Yeah, but see, Scotty Miller, like, hold on. Scotty Miller was saying, hold on, you so much you fall in love with me, but you on the phone all the time with A.B.
Well, he was.
So I don't really know how much you really.
Well, it's hard to argue with what A.B. used to be, right?
But Skip.
But is he that now?
But that's the thing, though, Skip. You had built up such a great rapport with this guy. Okay. This guy was really good on third down.
Right now, it's not looking like the smartest addition to a team that was playing at a high level.
But Skip, you know this. I mean, we're talking about Tom Brady has never had a guy rush for 100 yards in a Super Bowl game. He's won six of those.
Yep.
I mean, he's only had a couple of guys that's gone over 90 yards in the Super Bowl.
Okay.
And now we're asking, say, well, Tom, Skip, I told you, everything's got to be perfect around him in order for him to succeed.
Okay.
Skip, but that's what comes with age. It's okay.
Okay, but playing at the highest level at 6-2, and Pro Football Focus ranked him at that point the third best quarterback in football on performance, on rating, And then all of a sudden you throw AB into the mix and it starts to go south.
So
and
you're blaming AB for
I'm not, no, I'm not blaming AB. I'm blaming it. I'm blaming you, that's Tom's. It's on him.
Okay. Because,
okay. And you know what he was thinking? Pay me now so we can get paid later. Mm-hmm. Right? We're going to have to pay now so we can get paid with a Super Bowl right. at home. Because he's thinking, this guy could put us over the top, but we're going to have to try to figure it out on the fly. Well, I'm thinking, you can have Peyton Manning as the smartest quarterback ever. I don't know who you take. But to me, that guy's the highest IQ is that guy. If you give him 2 weeks in the middle of December to try to figure it out, I think he will. So I am excited to see what it looks like because I think it's going to look very different on Sunday. The whole off the scheme.
Oh, okay, okay, okay. So you said they're going to go back and they're going to do a lot of what Tom did originally.
I think it was finally enough time that you could practice enough and scheme enough and you have enough meeting time to redo all of it and say, let's throw all that out. Let's go back to this. I don't know what Antonio's role will be, but the last time I saw Tom Brady operating the last three quarters against my homeboy, he was on fire, and guess who fell out of the rotation? AB fell out of the rotation throughout the second half. Tom had two long scoring drives in the fourth quarter against Kansas City. AB caught no balls in the fourth quarter. So is it possible this Sunday against Minnesota, AB's going to be out of the rotation? It's possible. I doubt it.
It would be very interesting to see where a team is not they're going to stay with their defense because I thought Kansas City, after they got the lead, they kind of slacked off because, Skip, if you remember the first half, they basically blitzed Tom on every play.
Yep.
They had pressure on him, and then, they started backing off, and then they started to try to
– Although, in the middle of the third quarter, they went after him twice and got him twice on the two interceptions.
And he made a big-time throw. It was fourth down, and the one he hit, the deep ball to Chris Godwin.
Yep.
But, Skip, the thing is, look, they're going to have to run the football – to protect Tom, because if you ask Tom to just drop back and throw it 45, 50 times, you're asking for trouble.
Well, I would say that about just about anybody.
My homeboy, good.
Yeah.
A-Rod, you see A-Rod don't even matter. Mm. You don't see Skip the flick of the wrist.
Mm.
My homeboy he about to throw for 5,000 again.
Yeah, and that's the team that drafted a kid and then went out and signed a veteran because they're scared to death they can't run it enough to be a Super Bowl contender.
Skip, that was one of my concerns because they don't have a guy that third and short. Skip, you're on the goal line against Tampa. You got to be able to plunge that in there. And you had three cracks and you try to not even close. Mm. Edwards-Helaire is a nice change of pace, Skip. But sometimes, come playoff time, you're going to have to get some 31 and thirds and twos.
So, see, everybody needs a little running back help. Am I right?
No, your guy needs somebody to run for like 150.
Huh.
My guy needs somebody, the rest is on.
I'm going to bet on my guy on Sunday. When you finally gave him a little time to breathe, he's going to come out breathing fire.
Well, first of all, no Everson Griffin. He's in Detroit. Linval Joseph. Danielle Hunter's hurt. Stop it, Skip. They don't rush the passer.
Starts now.
The reason why Andy Dalton had success is why? Because he had protection. He got protected because they don't rush the passer anymore.
Mm.
You know that, and I know that. You think you're slick.
I thought he got protected pretty well the other night in Baltimore. Seriously, they sacked him one time.
Baltimore can't rush the quarterback.
Baltimore can run.
Who y'all play this week? Who y'all play Sunday?
Who, Dallas?
Yeah.
At Cincinnati. We're 3.5-point favorites. And I need us to lose so we can lose into their draft spot.
That's a shame. That's a shame. You're rooting for a loss.
Come to this.
This is going to be a fun. Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show. And be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.